So the question is, how good is this function that we build in order to do the classification? And you can't really answer that until you tell me what good means, all right? And what good means two things. First of all, what kinds of mistakes does our classifier make, all right? And for each of those mistakes, sort of how expensive is it to make those mistakes? And when we build a supervised classifier or supervised classification, since we know what the desired outputs are for a given set, and then we can run the thing as we're designing it, what we want to do is we want to minimize the expected misclassification cost, okay? We want to make mistakes as infrequently as possible, and the more expensive a mistake is, the less often we want to make that particular mistake. All right. To do this, to handle classification, there are two general strategies. The first method, which is referred to as generative, you basically use your training data from class A to build a model of class A. Separately, you build a model of class B, you build a model of class C, you build a model of class D, and then when you give a new example, you say, well, does model A explain it better, or model B, or model C, whichever one explains it better, that's the one I pick. And it's referred to as generative because the idea is that I have a model that describes sort of all the different possible things that would be of class A, at least that's the hope. Or you could even think of it as generating a set of examples that are class A. The other way of doing it is referred to as discriminative. Discriminative says, well, here's A and here's a bunch of things that are not A. And let me learn how to discriminate between them. Okay, so I'm not going to worry about modeling what all of A is. What I want to do is, if I only have A's, B's, and C's, I have to look at how would I discriminate between A or B's and C's. Or I could also do A versus B, A versus C, B versus C, and learn those. But the discriminative approach focuses on learning the boundary, the separator between our categories. Today, what we're going to be doing is talking about generative. And then we'll move on to discriminative in a couple of future lessons.